AJ Price off the screen high from Gavin Edwards and finds the lob to Stanley Robinson.
And Edwards, not a bad shot blocker himself, but the penetration by Price, who has turned more into a jump shooter.
20. We'll keep track of all that for you. Back to Philadelphia, Chattanooga, and UConn. Carter Blackburn and Jay Billis.
Stanley Robinson is a big time athlete. Jim Calhoun was telling me yesterday he thinks that Robinson is a better athlete overall than was Rudy Gay at UConn, and that is saying a lot. Rudy Gay, one of the top picks in the draft a few years ago, and Robinson, excellent second effort on the glass. He's able to get up so high. He's just got an extra step on his ladder.
Calhoun and everyone else knows that if Stanley Robinson can turn it up in the NCAA tournament the way he did at the end of the regular season, then UConn becomes an especially dangerous team.
Well, he thinks the light is starting to go on. Consistency has always been the issue with Stanley Robinson. It's never been a question of talent, but he has had some good games of late, especially his game against Syracuse, where he was magnificent. Referee's doing a good job of trying to calm the players down. Both Thabit and Goffney are jawing at each other. This is not the debate team. This is the NCAA tournament. They need to pipe down and play ball.
Robinson's resolution is a couple of made free throws and a four-point edge for the Huskies. Price down to the post. Adrian off the miss from Robinson.
Give me that shit.
A follow goes for Jeff Adrian.
That's what you call second effort. Bounces up the second time.
How about a third effort from Robinson? Who finishes on the other end. The block on one side for the junior out of Birmingham, Alabama, and finishes on the other end.
Well, Stanley Robinson is an incredible leaper off of 2 feet. His head was by the rim, and instead of just standing there and admiring his fine work, he ran the floor, caught the ball as the trailer, and was able to lay it in.
Robinson finishes the press offense.
Well, that's how you break a press. The pass, they got it into the middle, and those are the kind of passes that UConn can throw. Craig Ostrey, once he gets into the middle of the floor, can just lob it up. They're coming from everywhere. Hard to tell.
That's the beat-like block from Stanley Robinson.
Stanley Robinson ought to start wearing a helmet. He gets his head so close to the rim. Now watch him come in from the weak side here. Stokes goes up. I mean, that's a big-time leaper there that can get off of 2 feet right under the basket. Where I think UConn could really improve their zone attack. Not bad, but it's not great. This has just been a layup line. Turn this into a poster.
Ostrey steals it. Robinson looks it again. Stanley Robinson.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Stanley Robinson Show.
It is Mr. Robinson's neighborhood in Philadelphia.
First it was New York, now Philly.
Now, does that mean that if North Carolina doesn't win the championship, it would be a failure in intelligence gathering?
That could be.
51 is the lowest scoring output of a first-round game. Another alley-oop dunk for Stanley Robinson, this coming off the feed from Walker.
Most players don't get highlights like that over the course of their career, and he's gotten at least four or five dunks in this game that have been top-quality highlight reel material.
In the tournament, a steal off the inbound from Beverly. Robinson again.
And that one seemed a bit pedestrian in relation to the other dunks he's had, where his forehead has been near the rim.
24 now for Stanley Robinson. Mr. Alley-oop today for UConn. Hashim and the Huskies loving it.